or how we want. The Holy Spirit.
So
fall fresh.
That was it.
I said fall fresh. On us. Amen.
Amen.
I hope you're not too tired to give me some help. Amen. Amen. Well, we've been traveling to interstate this morning. I'm not talking about the highway. I'm talking about this morning.
Yes, sir.
Amen. When you do travel to interstate, you have to pull over to a rest stop. So if you need a rest stop to help me, you go ahead and rest a minute. Amen. Because I need some prayers and some amen.
All right.
Blessed Hope, Cleveland, Ohio. Amen. One more time. Amen. Good to see all of you here one more time. Some faces I know and some faces I don't know.
Yes, sir.
That's okay. Amen. You're a child of God. If you know something about the Lord, you don't mind saying amen. Matter of fact, amen, it's biblical. I said, amen. That means you agree with what has been said. One thing about preaching, amen, everything don't feel good all the time. But if it's good for you, you ought to say amen. Amen. Everything my wife cooked, I don't really like it. But I don't think she's going to cook nothing to poison me, amen. So I go ahead and eat. Different stuff. Is that right? Amen. But I do know that we have to have the Word of God to stay nourished in this Christian journey.
All right.
Not only folk will say stuff, they'll do stuff. Amen. Even folk in the church make do stuff sometimes and you want to cuss. Come on, talk to
them.
Amen. But thank God I'm on the rock. Amen. I do celebrate your pastor today. Amen. Pastor Carla. Amen. He's a true-hearted pastor and man of God. He's my friend. I can say that. Amen. Some folk is your associates. Amen. Some folk are your friends. There's a big difference. Some folk you hang around. Some folk you don't want to hang around.
Yeah.
Some folks you'd be glad to get out and around.
Yeah.
Amen. I must say, amen, I always, amen, love to be in his presence.
All right.
Amen. To the best wife in the world first, amen. That song, that song. Amen. I don't think it's wrong for her to want me to want her to sing while I preach. I think it's all right. I spend more time with her than I do anybody else. She know what kind of life I live. I know what kind of she live. Amen. So the other ministers of Blessed Hope and to their sons and daughter of Shady Grove, we call them ministers. Amen. From Hardy, Minister Carson, and Minister Richardson. To the greatest deacons in the world. Amen. From Shady Grove. I know Blessed Hope got some good ones. I brought some good ones with me. Amen. Give me a minute here. Just call the roll since I rolled so far. We rolled so far. Amen. Just give me a few minutes. Amen. You don't mind just talking. I do thank God for Shady Grove sacrificing and coming so people don't have to do what they do. Quit that for you. I really appreciate it. Amen. Shady Grove. They are good. pastor and they love the Lord.
Amen. All right.
We met your pastor some time ago through Reverend Hardy. Amen. And we love his presence and his son and his family. And Blessed Hope, don't get me wrong.
Amen.
But one time they were moving to Atlanta somewhere. They always running around somewhere down the road. When they come down, we can't even keep up with them. Amen. So he was moving to Atlanta and the bus broke down or whatever. Hey, Doc, I need some help. That's what you need. Bus broke down. That's what we got you. On the way. Amen. I felt so happy to help him. Amen. That was right then when that bond was really, amen, connected. A friend would get up in the middle of the night. I'm so glad I got a friend that watched over me all night long. His name is Jesus. The Lamb of God has taken away the sins of the world. Amen. There is a word from the Lord today, and I do solicit your prayers. And we have been praying. I wasn't sure, was it 32 or 33? But I thought I was right, so it was 33. Amen. Something about that word three and three.
All right.
Come on, talk to me.
All right.
You know anything about the Lord, if you ever heard any preaching, I know you know something about the word three. But anyway, let's go to a text here in the Gospels reported by St. Luke.
All right.
Amen. Amen. And I do like encouragement when I'm up because I try to encourage people.
All right. That's right.
I used to say my Easter speech and mama would. I look all over the audience when I found mama.
All right.
Gave me a nod. I threw my head back. And I said my speech. Amen.
That's
since
right.
I can't look at my wife and the audience, I'm going to look at all of y'all. Amen. Luke, 6th chapter. Your custom is standing, I want you to stand. Your custom is sitting, I want you to sit. Just be a doer of the word, not just a hearer only. We got a lot of folk here. We got a lot of folk coming to church, but on the show. Amen. But the Bible said the tree is known by the fruit that it bears. Amen. You an apple, you're not gonna bear no peaches. If you do, something wrong with your tree. Luke 6, chapter verse number 46. We're gonna talk about this house on the rock. Called the church. But today is Blessed Hope. And Shady Grove and all others. The word Jesus said here, and why call me ye Lord? And why call ye me Lord, Lord? And do not the things which I say. Whosoever cometh to me and heareth my sayings, doeth them, I will show you to whom he is like. He is like a man which built a house and dig deep. Get that word dig. Lay the foundation. You can't lay a foundation on a scratchy surface. And on a rock. When the flood arose and the steam beat, and that word means heavily, upon that house, amen, upon that house, and could not shake it, for it was founded upon a rock. But he that heareth and doeth not is like a man which, that without a foundation built a house upon the earth, against which, the steam beat heavily, immediately it fell. And the ruins of that house was great. Let's pray. God, we pray now that you would bless your word.
Yes.
Your word would be further clarified.
Yes.
And God, these thy people would be edified.
Yes.
And then, Lord, you be glorified.
Yes.
Bless us now, and we'll be careful to give you the praise. Give us preaching power. Hide me, our Father, behind your cross. Let me speak your word with clarity and power. In the name of Jesus, I do pray, and every heart said amen.
Amen.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I'm going to use a message from the Lord today. Amen. A house, or should I say a church built on a rock?
All right now.
Amen. A church built on the rock.
Yes, sir.
Even though we have congregations all over this country, there's only one church.
Amen.
Even though we are called Blessed Hope Missionary Baptist Church.
Yeah.
And I hope you understand the word missionary.
Yeah.
It's not mercenary. It is missionary. Missionary is supposed to carry out the word of the Lord. Matter of fact, a missionary person don't mind talking about the Lord anyway.
Amen.
Amen. You stop the line in Walmart.
Amen.
Talking about the Lord.
Yeah.
Come on, talk to me. Amen. Church built on the rock. Notice I didn't say a rock.
Mm-hmm.
Notice I said the rock.
The rock.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
And I found out that years ago they used to build houses and they used to use cedar blocks. They would cut cedar blocks. They did the best they could. Amen. But after a period of time, those cedar blocks would rot.
Yeah.
Even though that cedar would last longer than a pine, it would last longer than an oak tree, but the cedar eventually would rot.
Uh-huh.
Well, how you know that, Henry? Amen. I lived in one of those houses some years ago, and after a period of time, amen, my dad and mom did the best they could. But after a period of time, that cedar block began to give in.
Yeah.
And I found out that in the world, that if you build your life on the world, if you build your life on popularity, you build your life on good looks, you build your life on what you got, amen, it's going to fail.
Yeah.
Because if I build my house on how my house looks, when my house gone, I'm gone.
Yeah.
Come on, talk to me, church, amen. You got to build your house upon the rock that will never fail, upon a rock that never slumber nor sleep, upon a rock that watch over us all night long. His name is Jesus. That's why they call him a rock in a weary land. That's why they call him a shelter in the time of the storm. Amen. Somebody said he walks with me. He talks with me. He tells me I am his own. Amen. Church is built on a rock. The thing about it, amen, the Lord starts some, he finished. Amen. No, amen. When God got you, no devil in hell can take you down. If I'm right, amen. Somebody said, I'm wrapped up in the Lord. Tied up and tangled up in his grace and his mercy. Amen. God is good, I tell you. He's the one that brought us to Cleveland. Ain't that right? Amen. Devil even gave me some issues, but see, my God bigger than issues. Church that's built on the principles of the teaching of Jesus will stand against any opposition.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
And I found out also that when they preach and when a pastor want to stand for what's right, amen, friends may become few.
Yeah.
Don't talk to me. Amen. Amen. Popularity may put you down. Amen. But that's all right. Stand on the truth. You know what's right. Do what's right. Because I found out only God blesses what's right. Am I right about it?
Amen.
As the word of God from the Lord, from the bosom of the Lord here recorded by Luke. I have heard some people call him Dr. Luke. But as this message unfolds, we see Luke inspired writing. And as he talks about Jesus, he's referred to him as the Son of Man. Meaning he brings out more about Jesus' humanity than any other of the writers. Amen. Jesus was truly God in the human flesh.
Yes, sir.
You have a witness, have you?
Yes, sir.
He was God and he also was man.
Yeah.
Amen. He was God, he gave rest to the weary.
Yeah.
The man's side got hungry, the man's side got weak, but the God's side, I'm going to talk to me. Amen. He gave rest to the weary souls. I'm glad today that